Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for November the 10th of 2019, well, it is titled A Mercury Transit Sequence. So what do we see here? Well, this is an image of our sun, and we can see the surface of the sun, and we see a number of dark spots on it. And these spots are caused by two different things in this image. There are, off to the right-hand side and towards the center of the image, a few sunspots. Sunspots are darker, cooler areas on the surface of the sun. They are areas where the sun's magnetic field has become tangled and intensified, and therefore that inhibits the flow of energy to the surface and makes them cooler. They're not cold by any sense, but they are a couple thousand degrees cooler than the rest of the surface of the sun, and that makes them appear a little bit fainter. So if you could take that material out and put it out in space all by itself, it would glow very bright and be a reddish-orange color. Now the line of dots to the left-hand side of this image are actually images of the planet Mercury. Now, there are only two planets that can pass in front of the sun as seen from the Earth, and those are the two planets that are closer to the sun. They're the only ones that ever get in between us and the sun. And when they do, they can transit, and that means pass directly in front of the sun. Now, it's not a common event because everything has to be lined up perfectly. Because the orbits are slightly tilted, most of the time Mercury passes well above or well below the sun and does not actually cross its surface. But on occasion, it does pass in front, as we see here, from 2016, which is the last time a transit occurred. And at that point, the Mercury passed directly in front of the sun, and you can see those images taken roughly 15 minutes apart, so it took a couple of hours for it to pass across this portion of the sun. Now, this also happens with Venus, although on a much rarer scale, does not happen near as often with Venus as it does with Mercury. We also see this, in a way, with our moon when we talk about eclipses. An eclipse is when the moon passes in front of the sun, the difference there being that the moon appears much larger in the sky and can completely block out the sun, giving us an eclipse, whereas Venus and Mercury just appear as small dots, blocking out only a tiny portion of the sun's light. Now, the next transit is coming up tomorrow on November the 11th, and we'll block out, again, a small portion of the sun as seen from the Earth. So another chance to be able to see this kind of thing coming up, and the last chance for a number of years, because the next time it will occur is not until 2032. So after this, we have more than a decade to wait before Mercury will once again pass in front of the sun. Now, it's also interesting to mention that this is one of the methods that is used to detect planets outside of our solar system. And in fact, the vast majority of planets have been detected by this method. When things are lined up perfectly and the planet passes in front of the star, it will dim the light. And as you can see here, Mercury being in front of the sun will remove a little bit of the sun's light. And we can detect those dips, and when everything is lined up just right, we can measure that and use that to measure some of the properties of the orbit and learn about some of the planets. Now, it's unusual because things have to be lined up just right, just as they do in our own solar system, in order for us to be able to see this kind of thing. So it would not happen for everyone, but we are getting a number of planets and have now discovered thousands of planets outside our solar system using a method very similar to what we're seeing for the transit of Mercury here today. So that was our picture of the day for November the 10th of 2019. It was titled A Mercury Transit Sequence. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Inverted Moon Bumps. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.